Hey there, so I was just calling to say you're doing great work. You've got your first bit of custom data written into a database, and it only took a few minutes. Hey, JEP is calling. Hey JP, we just wrote our first data to Firebase, and we didn't even have to write a single async task or need to deal with threads.
I'm glad you like it.
Yeah, actually, while I have you on the phone, quick question. So you've looked at the dashboard longer than I have. So how is data actually structured in Firebase? It doesn't look like a relational database to me. So what is this Firebase data that I'm editing?
Well, you're right about it not being a relational database. So let me show you what it looks like. Let me pull up my screen.
First, SQL is a tabular format with columns and rows like Excel or a Google spreadsheet. However, in Firebase, data is stored in JSON. It's basically a simple declarative language used to describe objects and data. It's a lot more flexible than a tabular format since you don't need to strictly define rows or headings. JSON contains a nested structure similar to XML. And also, like XML, JSON can be represented in a tree structure.
Oh yeah, I remember JSON from working on developing Android apps. I think it was the format that both OpenWeatherMap API and the movies database returned.
Oh, and if your developer is unfamiliar with JSON, take a moment to close this hangout and check out the links provided in the instructor notes to get you up to speed.
All right, so if I'm understanding you right, the dashboard is basically a visualization of my JSON tree. And the Firebase object that we're calling methods on in the Android code, that's also an object representation of a JSON tree, right?
Yep.
Okay, so what kind of things can I actually store as values in JSON? It looks like here I stored a string as a key and a string as a value. So does that mean that any type that JSON normally accepts is okay?
Right. Let me explain.
Well, yes, mostly. The keys are always strings. The values stored in the tree can be passed in as booleans, longs, doubles, lists, maps, and some specific types of objects. There are also Java types that can be returned from the tree. Lists and maps can contain more lists and more maps, and objects can contain other objects or lists of other objects, meaning you can have nested data structures within data structures. I know the dashboard is pretty powerful when you want to look at your data, although it's hard to tell when you don't have too many entries. Here's a look at it right now.